fourth and final virtual game show, hosted by yours truly, Student Council. Before we get started, we want to give a big thank you to the Falcon Players and the Theater Department, as well as Mr. Ham, for helping us get this all together. I'm just going to introduce myself real quick. My name is Kiri Kenman. I'm one of your senior senators. I'm so excited to be here with three wonderful contestants, all of whom have won their own game show previously, so they're all experts already. But I'm going to go ahead and let them introduce themselves. We'll start with Edwin. Tell us a little bit about your club and what's your strategy for tonight.
Hi, my name is Edwin Uche. I'm a member of DECA. And DECA is a club that prepares emerging leaders and entrepreneurs in marketing, finance, hospitality, and management in competitive events. My strategy for tonight is just to believe in myself and have fun. Yeah.
Awesome, love to hear it. All right, we'll move on to Roman.
Hi, my name is Roman. I'm the president of the Speech Debate Club, and basically we just do a lot of events that revolve around public speaking, meaning that we either just like debate stuff that probably we'll never discuss ever again in our lives, or we'll just act stuff that we've probably never seen before. And my strategy is, look, I'm going to be honest, probably the stupidest one out of the three. My brain has the exact size and texture of a hard-boiled egg, so I'm just going to see how far I get and prove that luck, I mean pure luck, is way better than big brains.
You know what, if luck got you this far, I think you're pretty set. We'll go on to Jerry.
Hi, I'm in National Honor Society. I'm just in it. And we have the core tenets of like honesty, service, integrity, and character. And so, my strategy for tonight is like to answer the stuff I know, try to dodge the stuff I don't know, and hope that works.
Perfect. That sounds like a great plan. Honestly, I think you guys all have an amazing chance at winning tonight. And whoever wins tonight will be named the champion of, I guess, the next year. And you guys will get the coveted game show trophy, which we don't have with us tonight, but it's really cool. I can tell you that for a fact. So for our viewers who haven't tuned in before, I'll give you a basic rundown of how the game works. So we're going to go to each contestant. They're going to pick one question from the game board. They're going to have the chance to answer that question. If they answer correctly, they'll get those points. If they don't answer correctly, then the question will go to the next person down the line. And we'll just proceed that way until we have a winner. So they're really ready to get started? Yep. All right, awesome. So we're going to start with Edwin.
I will take world history for 300.
Alrighty. According to Greek mythology, who was the first woman on Earth?
Pandora.
That is correct. Awesome. Okay, Roman.
Same category, 500.
In Russia, what month did the October Revolution take place?
Oh my God, okay. I'm going
to
say May.
May? Very not close. Jerry?
November, but he hasn't listed. But I did know that because you're on the Gregorian calendar and you're on the Julian calendar. So, yeah.
Okay, you know what? That's a really good explanation. We're going to say that you knew the answer even though it was already up.
Right.
So, we'll give you those points.
I don't
know. Okay. Edwin, next question.
Oh, I believe it's history.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Jerry, go ahead.
Let's take world history for 400.
What year did Martin Luther post his 95 Theses, which began the Protestant Revolution?
1517, thank you, Ms. Pike.
Amazing, shout out to Ms. Pike for getting that date ingrained in our brains. And we'll go on to Edwin.
Great. Let's take pop culture for 300.
Who is the most listened to artist on Spotify in the entire world?
Who is Drake?
Close, but no. Roman?
The Beatles?
No.
Taylor Swift?
I wish, but no. The correct answer was The Weeknd. Okay, Roman? So finish this lyric from the first verse of the song Africa by Toto. I will not sing it, but I will read it out to you. Hoping to find some old forgotten words or ancient melodies, he turned to me and
whispered,
one more time, a little bit louder.
Hurry, boy, she's waiting there for you.
Perfect! That is the correct answer. Amazing. Also, your singing was totally on point. And we'll go off to Jerry for the next question.
World history for 200.
Who was the first female prime minister of Great Britain?
Margaret Thatcher, the Iron Lady.
Yes. Perfect. Oh my gosh, I'm going to have a really good game. You guys are awesome on it. Okay, back to Edwin.
I'm sorry. I noticed you moving the point. I thought speech and debate had.
Random facts for 300. Okay. Which country was Caesar salad invented in?
The United States.
No. Roman?
We would be Greece.
No, you would think, but no.
It's
out of the air. No. So sorry, guys. It was actually invented in Mexico. Little fun fact for you there. It's not named after the person Caesar. It was actually named after a chef. So. Okay, next question.
That was my turn. Sports fact. Nope. I'm not falling for that again. Random fact.
What language has the most words?
I think I know this.
I think you know it too, yeah. Gut feeling, what's your first response?
Mandarin.
No. So close. Jerry?
Cantonese.
Mm-hmm. Edwin?
Arabic?
No, it's actually. Wait, let me see if I'm right. English! So the language that we're all speaking right now. Okay, next question. This is Jerry.
Oh. Let's go world history for 100.
Who were the three main members of the Axis powers in World War II?
Nazi Germany, Fascist Italy, and then also Fascist Japan.
Perfect. Wow, you had the adjective there too? Amazing. All right, next question goes to Edwin.
Let's go with sports for 300.
What athlete has the current highest salary in the U.S.?
So is this highest earnings or
so this is
like
just salary, no earnings, so no like brand deals, just the salary.
I believe that is Stephen Curry.
You would be correct. Great job. And a quick point check-in. Ooh, we're still really close. DECA was 600, speech and debate was 500, NHS was 700. Wow, you guys are all killing it. Okay, next question goes to Roman.
Sports 500.
What team lost the Super Bowl 4 consecutive times?
Can I choose another?
You cannot choose another, unfortunately.
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
You got this. Gut feeling. What's the first thing that comes to mind?
Do you really want to know?
Yes, I really do want to know.
How the first words that came to mind were Red Sox, and now I have to see.
Okay, so Red Sox is not a football team. Even I knew that. But we'll go to Jerry.
Is it the Pittsburgh Steelers?
Let's see. Is it the Pittsburgh Steelers? Oh, I can't ask that. Wait, just kidding. Let me just find my place right here. Can someone please remember? Oh, it is not Pittsburgh Steelers. Edwin.
The Buffalo Bills?
It is! Oh my gosh, so good. Okay, next question.
Is it Jerry?
It's Jerry. Sorry, everyone. Let's go with random facts for 400.
How many moons does Mars have?
Two.
That is correct. Alright, next question goes to Edwin.
Let's take pop culture for 400.
Pop culture for 400? What was the name of the drummer from the Beatles? correct. All right, perfect. So for a final point tally for this half of the game, Deck is at 1,500, Speech and Debate at 500, and NHS at 1,100. And now we're going to go to a short commercial break. Thank you.
What is up, Falcons? I know, it's been a while since the Backyard Bros have been here for a little information update. But fear not, we are back for our final episode to give you a little rundown about the rest of the school year.
Seniors, our time as Falcons is coming to a close, but we gotta make sure our last couple weeks, I think maybe something like 30-ish days, that's all the time we have left, so we gotta make the most out of that.
So here's a little quick update and some tips about how you can make the most out of the rest of your senior year.
So we actually only have one quick announcement for you guys, but I don't know if you guys heard, but you probably have because it's everywhere. But the boys basketball team just took home a 5A state championship for Foothills, and we actually have the privilege to be joined by one of the team members now. So let me ask you, Fletcher, how does it feel to bring that state championship back home?
You know, it just feels amazing going down that weird road, coming back home to Tucson, just looking at all my guys holding that golden trophy, bringing it back home to Foothills. It's no better feeling, you know. I gotta shout out all my teammates. They're the ones that pushed everyone every single day. And to my boys, y'all are dogs. Alright guys, so on this segment of the episode, me and Jacob, we like to call it what's the do's and what's the don'ts. And on this episode, it's what's the do's and what's the don'ts on this last little portion of our school.
Okay, number one, what's to do's? Water bottles. As the weather heats up, as school continues on, it's gonna get hot. You're gonna get thirsty. What's to don'ts? The water fountains don't. They don't work. So make sure, bring your water bottle. Stay hydrated so you'll be big chilling when you're back at school.
What's to do's? Stay 6 feet apart, everybody. Do we really want to be spreading this virus around any longer? We're almost through this thing. Just stay a little bit apart. Come on, make everyone happy. What's to don'ts? Dap each other up, hug each other, kiss each other at school. What are we? We're not in 2019, people, come on.
Our final what's to do? Wear a mask, people. You don't want to be that one person that goes spreading around COVID, especially when we're almost through this thing. So let's keep everybody safe and wear that mask. What's to don't? Don't forget it, because if you forget it, you will be not allowed to come into school. So be sure to have your mask at all times when you're on school grounds. And seniors, are you worried that you might not have the accessories to look extra good at graduation? Fear not, because Student Council is providing a custom mask that will fit your cap and gown so you can pull up with a little extra drip at graduation.
Jacob, I don't know if your fans can see. I'm getting a little teary-eyed up here.
I know, Fletch, I know. As we wind down, it's getting a little tough. Goodbyes are going all around.
I know.
So
they're the hardest part.
It is in fact the hardest part. But for now, the Backyard Bros, Big Fletch and Jacob, we're signing off for now. But we will catch you.
We later. Hope to see you around school as well. We're great at making friends.
We hope you have a great rest of your school year.
Deuces.
Which football sport has the most state championships?
Tennis? Men's tennis? Or boys tennis?
No, sorry.
Football?
No.
Boys and adult?
No, unfortunately not. The correct answer is girls tennis. You are very
Who are two of the current department heads? We'll take any answer. No, those are administrators, not department heads. You want to give it a try, Gary?
Sure. Let's go with Ms. Fortunato and Mr. Martin.
You got one right. You want to give it a try, Eddie?
Mr. Reinhardt and Mr. Reyes?
Nope, I'm sorry, but correct answers are all those people. All right, Gary, let's give it a try.
Foothills history, 400.
What year was the school district founded? This one might surprise you.
Oh, school district, okay. Let's say 1943.
That is not the answer.
1992?
That is not the answer.
Oh, man, that's my answer. I'm gonna say 1992, too.
That is not the answer, as we know. It was 1931. Pretty crazy, isn't that? All right, back to Eddie. You choose now.
Let's go with Foothills History for 300.
What were the last two musical productions of the theater department?
I do not know.
Okay, it's Hello, Dolly and Disaster.
That is correct. Good job. All right, Roman.
Pop Culture 200.
What is the name of the paper company featured in The Office?
Thunderbird.
That is correct. Jerry, let's see it.
Frank Burke. Foothills History 200.
How many schools are there in the Catalina Foothills School District?
Can I count?
Yeah.
Okay. Does this include preschool?
Yes, it does. It does.
Okay. So preschool, Hanson, Middle, Ventana, Kennedy, and Hanson, remember? That's the 8.
That is correct. All right, back to Eddie.
Let's go with sports for 200.
What type of dancer is Misty Copeland?
Ballet.
That is correct. All right, Roman.
Pop Culture 100.
What is the highest grossing film of all time?
Is it still? I think it is.
That is incorrect. Jerry, you want to give it a try?
Avengers Endgame.
That is correct. All right, Jerry, your turn.
Let's go Random Facts 200.
What commonly known fruit is actually a member of the rose family?
The rose family?
Let's go papaya. That is incorrect. You want to give it a try, Eddie?
Sure. Peach.
That is incorrect. Roman?
Banana.
That is incorrect. The correct answer was strawberry. All right, Eddie, your turn.
Let's go with sports for 100.
How many players are on the court in a basketball game?
10.
That is correct. Good job. All right, Roman.
Here we go with random facts 100.
What is the largest type of deer?
Define deer.
Any animal with antlers.
Any animal with antlers, correct?
Any animal with antlers.
Define antlers. Actually, no. Moose.
That is correct.
Okay.
All right. Gary, Foothills History 100.
Yeah.
Who is the current athletic director?
I really don't know, but let's say Bishop.
That is incorrect.
I do not know, sorry.
You happen to know?
Me?
Yeah.
I think it was Smith.
No, that is incorrect. The current athletic director is acting Mr. Tulsovic. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, we have our winner. I tried to rhyme win,
points. So congratulations, Andy, for Becca for winning the game. Thank you, Roman and Jerry. You guys did amazing, and I love you both. Eddie, I love you as well. You're the winner, so I love you. Because you won, this is our temporary trophy as of now, so very enticing, I know. You should feel very proud about this. And thank you, everyone, for participating in this. Thank you, Mr. Ham. Thank you, Falcon players. Thank you for all you guys for participating.